Star Drive and Black Holes Part 2. Why is a black hole so dark? A photon hitting a black hole doesn't bounce back. A photon is no more than a quark moving in a special way. Here's a photon moved at the speed of light, see, cartwheeling through space. Since it's a quark, it gets absorbed in a quark gluon plasma. It doesn't bounce back and therefore making a black hole dark. A black hole does, however, redirect gravitons, hence pulling stuff in. It's made out of quarks, graviton, which means it's a bit heavy. It can deflect gravitons and pull stuff in. Hawking's radiation expels when matter strikes the edge of a black hole, knocking chunks off. You mostly notice the radiation coming from the outer perimeter, of course. Let's go back to a black hole. There you are. This is representing the pressure before it blows up, but before that, a black hole radiates Hawking's radiation from this perimeter. It's objects coming from the other side, hitting it, and thereby making these photons and electrons fly towards us. Another thing, why is the speed, the average speed of all matter, zero? So this universe has various objects traveling in all kinds of dimensions, but why is it in total zero? Well, imagine a black hole. It is created from all kinds of quarks coming from all kinds of directions. So together, that's zero vector. And the thing is, if it rotates, it cannot hold on to the quarks on the equator. So then it can never gain enough mass to explode.